Hi there, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to solve the next Python Hackerrank challenge, which is finding the percentages. I've got Hackerrank on the left and I've got a Jupyter notebook on the right because I want to show you how things work really quickly. Let's kick it off. Solve challenge, and like always, please read the task really carefully. So what is the task? The provided code stub will read in a dictionary containing key value pairs. Well, we know that in Python, dictionaries are key value pairs, which I'm going to show you very short, of name and marks. For example, Amir got 80 in mathematics. Sam got 75 in mathematics for a list of students. Print the average of the marks array for the student's name provided. So what will happen, the computer will say, okay, whose average do you want? And the user will say, I want Sam's average. And the computer will compute what is Sam's marks average in total, showing two places after the decimal. This is gonna get really important. I'm gonna show you how to do that. If you have seen my previous videos, you know that I call this part the execution part. Is essentially when you have bought the ingredients of pizza of here, which is your function. That's when you buy the ingredients for your pizza, and this is when you make your pizza using those ingredients. So let's make a function and call it student average, and we will pass something here. I am not gonna put it right now, and then we will do some calculations, and I'm putting the word pass as a placeholder. I'll come back and say what actually I want you to do. The example is here. For example, the student's name is Alpha. Their scores are 20, 30, and 40. Another student is Beta, 30, 50, and 70. And the user says, I want the average scores for Beta. And the computer will be like, okay, so Beta has 30 plus 50 plus 70 divided by 3 equals 50. So we should print 50 in the output. So that is pretty easy, but let's see first how the inputs are made. So we have an N, which I assume we are saying, how many students do you have? I have 3 students. Let me just run it against this example here. So I have 3 students. That comes from this N. Can you please start inputting their names and their scores so that I can store them in a dictionary that I made up here? I make an empty dictionary, and as I go on, I add people's details in there. And then I say, okay, whose average do you want? Do you want, for example, I have Krishna, Arjun, Malika, and then I say, can you please calculate the average of Malika's scores? And they say, okay, 56 is the result. So that's pretty easy. But before I run you through how to do it here, let me first really quickly show you how to run a for loop on a dictionary. That's really important. I'll call it my dictionary. I have first person is Krishna, who scored a list of 67, 68, and 69. Well, it doesn't matter. I don't really have to be very accurate, but I'm doing my best. So then I have Arjun, who scored a list of 70, 98, and 63. They didn't really do well in the last one. And then I have Malika, who scored 52, 56, and 60. So this is the dictionary. Let's look at that. If I print it, you will see that this is how the dictionary looks like. If I want to run a loop on this dictionary, if I'm only interested in the first parts, which is their names, we call them keys. These are the keys. These are the values. So that always is like that. So key and value. So if I'm only interested in key, I will say for key in my dict.keys, oops, I need a colon, print key. You will see that I only get Krishna, Arjun, and Malika. If I'm interested in value, I can do that with dictionary.values. Sorry, I'm not printing key, I should print value. So I'm printing their scores now. What if I'm interested in both key and value? Okay, so give me key and value in dictionary items. So you will see that if I print the key value pair, I will have Krishna scored that, Arjun scored that much, and Malika scored that much. So I think this should give you a hint on how I'm going to be tackling this challenge. So let's go up. We will say, okay, I want you to give me a list of student marks. So give me the, a dictionary of student marks, and then give me the query name. Tell me whose score are you interested in getting an average of? Well, now we know how to run over a dictionary. We will say for key value pairs in what is a dictionary called? Student marks dot items. Go through the key value pairs. And if that person's key equals the query, because we know that the keys are these names. If you see that this key equals this query name that the user gave me, user told me to look at Malika's scores. So if you see Malika coming up, so if key equals the query name that the user gave me, now we have found Malika's scores because we have the values here as well. If key equals query of that, I want you to say average score equals. How do we calculate the average score of Malika? Then you say average score equals. I know how to find the average. I will add them all together. So sum all the values together. For example, if that's for Malika, I will say 52 plus 56 plus 60. Add them all together and divide it by length of value. So how many are there? 1, 2, and 3. So this will be easy. And then you can just simply come down and say print average score. Let's run this and see if it's gonna work. But remember, I have prepared my pizza ingredients. I haven't really done the execution part. All I need to do is just to run my pizza making or averaging function on the student marks and query name. I think this is not going to run very successfully because we didn't really care about 2 decimal points. I think I was right. Look, our output is 56.0, but what they're expecting is 56.00. Okay, that's pretty easy. All you need to do is to add quotation marks here and format your average score. You're changing the format, but is this enough? No, you need to open and close curly bracket, put a colon dot to F. This is standard. If I wanted 6 decimal points, I would put 6 here. If I wanted 1, I will put 1. So what this will do, it will, instead of giving 56.0, it will give 56.00. Let's run it again. Ta-da, it worked. So we have 56.00 and that's correct. Let's submit it for final all tests. Brilliant, it worked. I would really appreciate if you like this video and subscribe to my channel because that will help me grow my audience and help and reach a lot of people out there. Thanks a lot. I also earned my 3rd star. Ta-da!